Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, has stated that it is highly likely that the company will be ready to attempt its first orbital Starship launch in November of 2022. And it is even possible that the launch could take place as early as the end of October. But there are still many major obstacles to overcome. Stay tuned till the end of the video to know more about this. Musk took to Twitter on September 21st to provide a bit more specific insight into the company's next steps towards a crucial orbital launch debut. This information came as an addition to a welcome burst of insight into SpaceX's fully reusable Starship rocket program, which Musk had previously provided. Unexpectedly, SpaceX's CEO announced on September 19 that the Starship booster B7, currently assigned to that debut, would be rolled back to the factory for unspecified robustness upgrades. This move came directly after a seemingly successful and record-breaking static fire test. 2 days later, Musk has indicated that those upgrades might involve fortifying Super Heavy Booster 7 and its thrust section in order to ensure that it can survive failures in Raptor engine operations. With 33 Raptor V2 engines powering it, and plenty of evidence that those Raptors are far from having perfect reliability, the concern is understandable, even if the response is a bit different from what SpaceX's norm is in this situation. Before getting ready to launch Starship into orbit for the first time, SpaceX rushed through the development of Starship as if it wanted to break as many rockets as possible, which to some extent it did. Instead of spending 6 to 12 months tinkering with the same few prototypes without ever attempting a launch, SpaceX has been cranking out Starships and test articles and putting them through rigorous testing. A couple of times, SpaceX pushed a little too hard and made mistakes that could have been avoided. However, the majority of the failures produced large amounts of data that were then used to improve future vehicles. The high-altitude Starship flight testing was the project's holy grail. It required SpaceX to finish, test, and launch a new Starship 5 times in 6 months, and it culminated in May of 2021 with the first fully successful high-altitude Starship launch and landing. In contrast, SpaceX's preparations for its orbital flight test have been almost unrecognizable. In the 16 months that have passed since the launch and landing of SN15, SpaceX has made a significant amount of progress. However, it is abundantly clear that the company has chosen not to take any significant risks. After spending over 6 months slowly finishing and testing Super Heavy Booster 4 and Starship 20, the first orbital class pair, SpaceX never even attempted a single Booster 4 static fire and abruptly retired both prototypes without even attempting to fly either one of them. Without information from Musk or SpaceX, it is possible that we will never know why SpaceX canceled the B4 and S20 missions, or why the company appears to have revised its development strategy to be a bit more conservative after clearly demonstrating that moving quickly and taking big risks can be effective. It is possible that winning a $3 billion contract that places Starship front and center in NASA's attempt to return astronauts to the moon has encouraged a more cautious approach. The contract places Starship as the primary vehicle for carrying out NASA's mission. Before continuing with our video, if you guys haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button and ring the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video. In April of 2021, SpaceX was awarded the contract. Even though it is in its third, more cautious phase, the development of the Starship is still extraordinarily hardware-rich. It is moving quickly, and instead of learning from flight tests, many problems are being discovered on the ground. However, this does not alter the fact that the third phase of Starship development, which began in the second half of 2021 and is still ongoing, is proceeding with a greater degree of caution than the first and second phases, which took place between the first and second quarters of 2021. Despite this, it seems as though SpaceX is finally moving closer and closer to the first orbital launch of Starship. Musk claims that the company could be prepared for the first launch attempt as early as the end of October, but he describes a launch attempt in November as highly likely. He believes that SpaceX will have two pairs of orbital-class starships and super heavy boosters ready for orbital flight by then, which could make it possible for the company to quickly return to flight after the initial attempt. Musk is also enthusiastic about the Super Heavy Booster 9, which will feature many design changes and a thrust section that will fully isolate all 33 Raptors from one another. This is an important feature as it will ensure that the failure of one engine will not cause damage to the remaining ones. While this was going on September 19th, Super Heavy Booster 8 was rolled out to the launch pad, just as Musk had predicted that it would be. Booster 7 is currently being upgraded back at the factory, so Super Heavy Booster 8 will likely undergo proof testing in the near future. Despite the fact that this may be encouraging, past experience has shown that reality, particularly in the case of the Starship's first orbital launch debut, can be quite a bit different than the pictures that Elon Musk paints. Specifically, Musk anticipated that SpaceX would carry out the first Super Heavy static fire at Starbase's orbital launch pad later that month in September of 2021. As an example, Musk made this prediction. In point of fact, that extremely important test did not take place until 11 months later on August 9th of 2022, and it utilized a totally different booster. This to say that SpaceX has a significant amount of work left to do, almost all of which lies in uncharted territory, despite the fact that there has been significant progress made over the course of the past few months. Starship 24, which recently finished its first six-engine static fire earlier this month, is currently undergoing some strange modifications that seem to imply that the upper stage is not living up to SpaceX's expectations. These modifications are currently being made while Starship 24 is in the process of completing its second static fire. It is not yet clear whether or not there will be a need for additional testing. After completing a 7 Raptor static fire with great success, Super Heavy B7 is now on its way back to the factory for further maintenance. Once it has returned to the launch pad, the sequencing isn't entirely clear, but SpaceX will need to complete the first full Super Heavy wet dress rehearsal, which involves fully loading the booster with thousands of tons of flammable propellant, and the first full 33 Raptor static fire. It is not yet clear whether SpaceX will stick with its more cautious approach, which involves testing 1, 3, and 7 engines over the course of 6 weeks, or whether it'll go straight from testing 7 engines to testing 33 engines. In addition to that, it is not clear how Ship 24 factors into that picture. SpaceX will eventually need to, or should, conduct a full wet dress rehearsal of the fully stacked Starship. They may even want to attempt a 33-engine static fire with that fully fueled two-stage vehicle to truly test a rocket under the same conditions it'll launch under. Will SpaceX complete the stacking of B7 and S24 as soon as the booster returns to the pad, putting a potentially flight-worthy Starship at risk during the riskiest Super Heavy tests to date? The previous year's activities at SpaceX suggest that the company will choose caution and conduct 33-engine static fires before and after stacking, which could potentially double the amount of testing that is required. If SpaceX decides to gradually build up to 33 engines, which is the approach that all of the Booster 7 activity to date suggests SpaceX will take, then one or several additional tests will also be required. This will be the case whether SpaceX decides to gradually build up to 33 engines or not. In either case, it'll be a significant obstacle for SpaceX to meet its goal of having a fully stacked Starship that is ready for launch by the end of November. If any significant issues arise during any of the several unprecedented tests, it is likely that Musk's predicted schedule will become impossible to adhere to. The FAA has not yet granted SpaceX a license or experimental permit for orbital Starship launches, and the approval of either one is contingent on dozens of mitigations. This leaves the door open for an unpredictable outcome. this is not to say that an attempt to launch an orbital Starship during the month of November is completely out of the question. However, when taking into account the numerous problems that Booster 7 and Ship 24 have encountered during much simpler tests, it is becoming an increasingly unlikely scenario that SpaceX will be ready to launch the pair before the year 2022 comes to a close. So that's all for today's video. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. And if you want to watch more videos like this one, then hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you will always be notified.